Welcome to the highlights from the 2008 Prep Bowl. My name is Kevin Merkel. I'm an associate director at the league and the director of officials program, and it's my pleasure to introduce this year's version and our officials highlights from last year's Prep Bowl. Remember that the purpose of this highlight film is to not only show our officials making great calls, but also to instruct and show where we can improve as officials. What we do is certainly not to embarrass anyone at all, but instead to be an educational experience for all of you. We hope you enjoy this year's version. I'd like to introduce the person who will be narrating the rest of the program. This is Bob Meslow, our head rules clinician, and we thank him for all of his great efforts and the leadership he provides for our program, and we'll turn it over to Bob.
Thanks, Kevin. The first play we're going to show is one of those nightmares that immediately get your head in the rule book. R signals for a fair catch. There's fair catch interference, and before the ball is possessed, there's an inadvertent whistle. Boom, the interference, then the whistle, now the recovery. The correct ruling in this situation is because the foul was on the kicking team, R has the option of taking an awarded fair catch at the spot of the foul, or going back to the previous spot and having kicking team assessed a 15-yard penalty. The ruling is because the inadvertent whistle occurred after the foul. Check number 57, Team A. Did he make a block in the back? It appears that way. It also appears as if the umpire had the best look at it. He makes a pivot, takes a look, but obviously determines that there was not a block in the back. The receiver at the top of the screen, by all reports, came onto the field late, after the team had broken the huddle. And because this is a nine-man game, it gets a little trickier. We don't have him inside the numbers. The nine-man rule is that they must be within 7 yards at the time, rather than inside the numbers. So looking at that fellow at the top of the screen, the player at the top of the screen, and assuming that he came in late, let's look at the play and then determine what kind of penalty should have occurred. He goes deep, it's a perfect pass, gains about 20 or 25 yards. Assuming that the receiver did enter the field late, the best way for the officials to have handled this situation would have been for the wing official to immediately blow the play dead and charge Team A with a 5-yard illegal substitution penalty. Because this did not happen, and the player did participate, now we're looking at a 15-yard illegal participation penalty. So the moral of the story is, if you can shut it down and enforce the lesser of the two penalties, that clearly is the best way to go. This is an excellent bit of officiating by the wing official at the top of the screen. Took his time, reviewed the play in his mind, and made the great call. Let's see what we think of this intentional grounding call. I think we also have a hold on 97. The wing official is signaling incomplete. Typically, it's R's call. It appears that R and the umpire are doing the discussion on grounding or whether or not there was a player in the immediate area. Ultimate ruling was that it was intentional grounding. Concern being, did the wing official come in and participate in that discussion? It didn't appear that way. Textbook coverage by the wing official. He backs off, gets out of the way, makes an absolutely correct spot. Note the excellent coverage by both the wing official and the back judge as they come together on this beautiful touchdown run. You'll see by the clock that this is the first play of the second half. Free kick out of bounds, importance of being ready for anything to happen, especially in the opening kickoff for the first play of the second half. Correctly spotted, the options are inbound spot, 25 yards in advance of the free kick spot, or re-kick 5 yards behind the initial free kick spot. Quality officiating ruled inbounds. But watch the covering official. He goes to the spot. Instead of turning and continuing to officiate out of bounds, he turns and officiates in toward the field of play. Remember, you must cover those players out of bounds. Again, quality textbook officiating by the wing official. Watch the way he slides to the goal line on the snap, backs off, and is right there to make the correct call. One of the most difficult judgment calls that the referee is called upon to make during the course of a game. See the ball come out, tackles made at the same time. What are you ruling? Forward pass or fumble? I've always felt a good rule of thumb on this play is the direction of the ball. If the ball comes out forward, when in doubt, rule of the forward pass.